So an increase in the size of barge unloading crew at Port of New Orleans has resulted in new priority distribution for daily unloading rates. In particular, table 15.11 from the book may be revised. So they have given us a revised table and we can use the earlier data. And they want us to re-simulate 15 days of barge unloadings and compute the average number of barges delayed, average number of nightly arrivals, average number of barges unloaded each day and so on. First make those two tables, one for arrival, one for unloading. So because we have to simulate for 15 different days, so first column is day. So what we can do is, as we had done earlier, we can use the first and second column. So we use the column starting with 52 for the first random number and second column starting with 06 for the second one, so that we keep things separate. So these are all the numbers from the first column and second column. So using these two random numbers, two set of random numbers, we can use the above table for arrival, for example. And the first number is 52, which lies in this range. So arrivals will be 3. Second is 37. So 37 lies in this range. So number of arrivals is 2 and so on. So let me write down. Similarly, first number is 6 for the unloading and 6 lies in this range. So that means 2 will be unloaded. So I'm going to write 2 here. For 63 in this range, 4 will be unloaded. So I'm going to write 4, same thing for 57, so 4 and so on. So if you actually add this, this is total arrivals, 48, and this is total unloadings, 47. Now let's complete other columns also before we do further calculations. So on the first day, number delayed from previous days, we are starting with 0 and 3 have arrived. So total to be unloaded is also 3, but only 2 will be unloaded, as you can see from the last column. So remaining one goes to the next day, but that day you get 2 more. So the total to be unloaded becomes 3, and all the, in fact, you can unload up to 4. So obviously nothing is delayed. So this becomes 0 on the third day. Now you get 4 to be unloaded, and all the 4 get unloaded. So next day 0, 3 to be unloaded, and only 1 gets unloaded. So on the fifth day you start with 2 backlog. 5 more arrive, so now you have 7 to be unloaded, and you can unload only 5, so remaining 2 goes to the next day, and plus 5 again is 7, but you can unload only 3. As you can see, you can unload only 3 out of 7, so 4 goes to, 4 is the backlog starting on day 7. You get 2 more barges, 6. You can do only 4, so 2 remaining, 3 plus 2, 5, you can do only 3, so 2 remaining, you get 4 more, so 6, and you can do only 3, so remaining 3 goes to 10th day, 3 plus 4 is 7 to be unloaded, you can do 3, so 4 remains, again 7, 4 plus 3 is 7, you can do only 3, so 4 remaining. 4 plus 1 is 5. You can do 5. So day 13, nothing. You get 2 more. Both are unloaded. 0. You get 4 more. 1 can be unloaded. So 3 remains. 3 plus 3 is 6. And 4 unloaded. So 16 days will be 2. So anyway, we stop at day 15. So if you look at this, total delays. So with these numbers, you can easily calculate what is asked in the question. Average delays will be 27 divided by 15 comes to 1.8 per day. Average arrivals is 48 divided by 15 because there are 15 days. Similarly, 47 divided by 15 is 3.1. So this is one example of application of simulation to solve queuing problems. Before we start, if you look at queuing or even inventory models, they are fixed time increment models. Now, how this maintenance example is different is this is next event increment model. So let's use the data from the book. So this is available. So all these probabilities are collected from the historical data and converted from frequency information. And then you have the cumulative probability. And then you can easily write down random number interval. So this is the time between machine failures table. Similarly, we have data on repair times. So once the machine fails and it goes to the maintenance department, so how much time they take to repair the machine. So using these two tables, we can do the maintenance analysis. So the columns we are going to use, the first column is going to be breakdown number, and we are going to simulate 15 breakdowns. So obviously we are going to use random number for that, and then time between breakdowns. For the first random number, let's use the column starting with 99, then 29, then 27, and so on. And for repair time, we can use last column like 07, 60, and so on. So let's fill that column first. So now if you look at the first table above, so 99 is in this range. So that means the time between machine failure will be 3 hours. So that will be 3. Next one, 29. So 29 is here. So it will be 2 hours. So after 2 hours, machine will fail, and so on. 07. So same process. The first number is 07. So 07 lies in this range because we have to look at the second table now. This is for repair time. So 07 means it will take 1 hour to repair. This one is coming from here. Next is 60. It is somewhere here. So it will take 2 hours, and so on. So we can fill the remaining columns like this. So we have the random numbers. Now let's say time of breakdown. So I'm using some number here. Let's say we are starting at 3 o'clock. So first breakdown is, let's say, at 3 o'clock. So time repair person free. So we assume that in the beginning this person is free. Now how much time it will take for repairs? It will take 1 hour. So repair will end at 4 o'clock, and downtime will be 1 hour. If you go to the second breakdown now, second row, so second time between second breakdown is 2 hours. So next one is going to occur at 5. Repair person was free from 4 o'clock and this repair will take 2 hours. So because the failure is going to occur at 5 and it will take 2 hours, so it will end at 7 o'clock. So downtime will be 2 hours. So next failure is after 1.5 hours, so 6:30. This person is free at 7 now. So it has to wait, that machine has to wait for 1/2 hour before a repair can start. And once it starts, it will take 2 hours, so it will finish by 9. So your downtime becomes 2.5 hours. So next failure will occur after 2.5 hours, which is 9. Because 6.5 hours plus 2.5 is 9 hours. And this person is free from 9. So immediately this person has to work on the next failure. And this will be done in 2 hours. So downtime will be 2. The next failure will occur after 3 hours. So 9 plus 3 is 12. And this person is free from 11. So immediately repair can start. It will finish in 2 hours. So from 12 to 2 is 2. And downtime is 2. Next failure 2.5. This person is free from 2. So immediately can be started and finished by 2:30 to, it will take 3 hours, so 5:30. So downtime will be 3 hours, which is basically the repair time. Next failure will occur after 2.5 or 2.5 hours. So it will occur at 5 p.m. or 5 o'clock. This person is free only from 5:30, not available immediately. So from 5:30 to 2 hours, it becomes 7:30. And now you have 2.5 hours of downtime. Eighth breakdown, again after 2.5 hours, so 7:30. And this guy is free from 7:30. That's good. So immediately work can start and finish within 1 hour. So downtime is only 1. Then you have 10. And this is free from 8:30. So 1 hour means by 11, it's done. Only 1 hour. Next is 12 after 2 hours. And this guy is free from 11. So no problem. But it is going to take 3 hours now. So it will be done only at 3 hour downtime. Then you have 1:30 available from 3, 2 hour. So this will delay the thing by, so it will take 2 hours means it will be done only by 5. So you have a total downtime 3.5 hours. Next failure. Again, after 1.5 hours means 3. And this guy is only available from 5. And repair will take 3 hours, so 8. So now, downtime increases to 5. 13th repair after 2.5 hours. So 5:30. But repair person is available only from 8. So it is going to take 2 hours, so it will be done at 10. The next one is 2, so 7:30. And this person is free, available only from 10 plus 2 is 12, so again 4.5. And then 9:30. but this person is free from 12 plus 2 is 2 4.5. So this way you can see how we can simulate how much time it is going to take for each repair and what will happen to the downtime, downtime for the machines and so on. And you can see how efficient this setup is going to be based on the data available, based on the probabilities for time between machine failures and how much time it is going to take for repairs.